Imagine a bustling street in Tehran. Crowded sidewalks, concrete buildings filled with vibrant energy, and children absorbed in games that subtly teach logic, strategy, and perseverance. From these seemingly ordinary streets arose an extraordinary figure, Maryam Mirzakhani, whose quiet brilliance propelled her to the pinnacle of mathematics. In 2014, she became the first woman and the first Iranian to win mathematics' highest accolade, the Fields Medal. But her path to this honour was as intricate and compelling as the mathematical landscapes she explored, cut short by her untimely demise at a young age of 40. Maryam Mirzakhani was famously modest and deeply private, yet beneath her quiet demeanour was an indomitable spirit, a thinker with an uncanny ability to see beauty in complexity. Colleagues describe her as quietly relentless, a mathematician who pursued questions not for recognition but from genuine curiosity and an intense passion for discovery. Her workspace at Stanford University resembled an artist studio more than a traditional mathematician's office. Sprawling sheets of paper strewn across the floor, covered in intricate sketches and equations, capturing the depth of her imagination. To her daughter, Anahita, these sheets were simply mummy's paintings. But to her peers, they symbolised the meticulous craftsmanship of a mind constantly exploring the frontiers of understanding. Mirzakhani's mathematical genius lay primarily in her groundbreaking exploration of hyperbolic geometry, an area concerned with surfaces that curve in ways dramatically different from flat or spherical spaces we experience daily. Imagine surfaces shaped like saddles or donuts, infinitely stretched or twisted. These abstract shapes became her intellectual playground. Her landmark doctoral thesis developed novel methods for precisely counting and categorizing the closed loops, known as geodesics, that traverse these complex surfaces. This intricate counting created connections between geometry, algebra, and dynamics, illuminating previously obscured relationships within mathematics. This show celebrates Mirzakhani's extraordinary journey and lasting legacy. Born on May 12, 1977 in Tehran, Maryam grew up in a home committed to intellectual exploration. Her family fostered curiosity and celebrated learning as a virtue, more important than mere academic success. Her father, an electrical engineer, frequently engaged young Maryam with puzzles, riddles, and logic games, laying the foundation for her unique way of seeing the world. Yet initially, mathematics was not her primary passion. Maryam's early love was literature. She spent countless hours immersed in novels, enchanted by stories that could transport her to worlds entirely unlike her own. Maryam's early school years were marked by Iran's challenging societal backdrop, shaped by the aftermath of the Iran-Iraq War. Schools and resources were limited, yet her resilience flourished. It was in middle school that Maryam's path shifted distinctly toward mathematics. She discovered the captivating allure of solving complex mathematical puzzles. She often recounted an inspiring moment when her older brother explained a famous mathematical problem, adding numbers from 1 to 100, famously solved by the mathematician Gauss, as the first instance where mathematics genuinely intrigued her. Alongside her close friend and fellow mathematician Roya Beheshti, Maryam began attending math clubs regularly. Their favourite haunt was a bustling street lined with bookshops near their school in Tehran. Here, they would buy random books, discovering mathematical treasures and inspirations hidden within their pages. Soon, Maryam's exceptional talent became unmistakable. She rapidly excelled, leaving her teachers astounded by her intuitive grasp of complex concepts. At 17, Maryam's brilliance captured international attention. She participated in the International Mathematical Olympiad, IMO, earning gold medals in consecutive years, 1994 and 1995, and achieving a perfect score in her second appearance, a feat unheard of for Iranian students at the time. This international success opened doors previously unimaginable, eventually leading her to the United States, where she pursued further studies at Harvard. Maryam Mirzakhani's research revolved around hyperbolic geometry, a field that examines surfaces markedly different from the familiar flat plane or spherical globe we commonly encounter. To visualize these surfaces, imagine a donut or a saddle, each curved in distinctive ways. Unlike a sphere, a donut shape, technically called a torus, features a single hole, fundamentally changing its geometric properties. Similarly, more complicated shapes, whimsically referred to as a pair of pants, incorporate multiple holes. Such surfaces are staples in Mirzakhani's mathematical universe. Her primary fascination was with moduli spaces. Imagine a flexible rubber donut in your hands. You can stretch, twist, or compress it into numerous shapes without tearing the material. Each distinct shape the donut can take represents a unique point within a moduli space, essentially a comprehensive catalogue of every possible form a particular object can have. To draw an analogy in two-dimensional space, think about the rectangles that share the same area. Although they may vary widely in length and width, some long and thin, others short and broad, their area remains identical. Each unique length and width combination defines a distinct configuration within their moduli space. Within these moduli spaces, she unraveled the mysteries of geodesics, or the shortest possible loops you can draw on a surface without intersecting themselves, much like carefully wrapping a rubber band around a donut without letting it cross over itself. One of the central problems she tackled was determining the longest possible simple loop on such a surface before it inevitably intersects itself. To address this, she ingeniously combined geometric intuition with powerful mathematical inequalities. Her insights allowed mathematicians to bound these loop lengths and precisely count how many such loops exist on complex surfaces, establishing a fundamental bridge between geometry, algebra, and number theory. Her work extended to dynamical systems, specifically analysing trajectories of particles confined to intricate spaces, much like a billiard ball endlessly bouncing around a uniquely shaped table. What initially appeared random and chaotic, she revealed, contained hidden yet precise structures. Using sequences and infinite series methods, she identified clear underlying patterns in these seemingly erratic movements. This research culminated in the renowned magic wand theorem, developed collaboratively with mathematician Alex Erskine, demonstrating that these particle trajectories were not random at all, but governed by exact mathematical rules. Mirzakhani's discoveries provided critical mathematical frameworks directly relevant to applied sciences. Her insights into moduli spaces and complex geometric structures have helped physicists better understand the mathematical underpinnings of particle motion and energy states in quantum mechanics. In particular, her work has influenced theoretical models that describe electron behavior and particle interactions, which are central to quantum field theory. Additionally, her study of dynamical systems has implications for cryptography, specifically in developing algorithms and secure communication methods reliant on complex mathematical structures. By identifying hidden regularities in chaotic-seeming systems, she provided foundational tools that researchers now use to model complex natural phenomena and technological challenges, from secure data encryption to predicting orbital mechanics in astrophysics. Mirzakhani's extraordinary talents came fully into view during her graduate studies at Harvard University, where she worked closely with her advisor, Curtis McMullen, himself a Fields Medal recipient. Her doctoral thesis tackled challenging problems within hyperbolic geometry and dynamical systems, specifically addressing fundamental questions around geodesics that we talked about. Her groundbreaking thesis provided novel methods to precisely calculate the number of these simple loops on complex surfaces, known as Riemann surfaces, based on their length. Previously, mathematicians could estimate how these loops multiplied as their lengths increased, but precise counts and clear patterns had remained elusive. Mirzakhani developed innovative approaches by connecting geometric insights with advanced techniques from algebra and analysis. She utilized clever applications of integration and inequalities. In 2014, Mirzakhani received the Fields Medal, the most prestigious honor in mathematics, awarded only every 4 years and exclusively to mathematicians under 40. Her selection marked a historical milestone. She was the first woman and the first Iranian recipient since the prize's establishment in 1936. The award specifically recognized her stunning contributions to understanding dynamics on complex geometric surfaces, highlighting how her research fundamentally reshaped perceptions of mathematical possibility. Yet despite this global acclaim, Mirzakhani remained notably modest and private. When media attention became intense following her Fields Medal announcement, a protective circle of fellow female mathematicians, humorously dubbed the MM Shield, stepped in to help her manage unwanted publicity gracefully. Those who collaborated with her recall her quiet determination, unwavering optimism, and extraordinary humility, which stood in contrast to her monumental professional accomplishments. Away from academia, Maryam found joy and solace in Persian poetry, calligraphy, and violin. She married Czech mathematician Jan Vondrak, and they had a daughter, Anahita, whose presence enriched her life immeasurably. Those close to Mirzakhani describe her as exceptionally kind, thoughtful, and humble, moving quietly through the corridors of Stanford University with her characteristic warm smile. In 2013, at the peak of her intellectual powers and amid profound professional recognition, Mirzakhani was diagnosed with breast cancer. Throughout her illness, she displayed the same quiet courage that characterized her work. Even in declining health, she continued to tackle complex mathematical problems with her signature determination, leaving behind notes and unfinished ideas that continue to inspire researchers. Maryam Mirzakhani passed away on July 14, 2017, at just 40 years old. In her short life, Mirzakhani had already given the world enough to inspire generations. Her enduring legacy lives. Her life and work have sparked global initiatives aimed at encouraging women in mathematics. Each year on her birthday, May 12, the world commemorates International Women in Mathematics Day in her honour. Fellowships, conferences, and scholarships bearing her name support a new generation of mathematicians. Today, mathematicians worldwide continue exploring the frontiers Maryam opened, extending and deepening her work. Mirzakhani's ideas have sparked breakthroughs, from understanding quantum systems to unraveling pure mathematical mysteries.